molecules are elegant. They're really elegant. They're designed so perfectly by nature. And, you know, how they're just put together. You can't help but have an emotional response to molecules. I mean, we have an emotional response to molecules all the time. I'm looking at these trees, and what I'm responding to in the autumn colours is molecules. And beneath your seats, what you will find is some little containers, and in those containers, yeah, there's some smells. And all I want you to do now is to take the vials and pass them around and just smell them and see the different smells you experience. A lot of popular lecturers, they'll give big bangs and demonstrations of fireworks. Well, that's fine. You know, I actually do explode a hydrogen balloon because I like to get people's attention and, you know, just raise their interest right at the beginning. Oh, do you know, I hate that. I really don't like doing that. Now, you know, what I really want to communicate is my passion for it. You know, I'm absolutely passionate about it. You know, what really turns me on, I think what turns on most people is ideas. I mean, you know, being able to use your imagination. And yet all around us is, you know, this world hidden below the surface of visible reality where the most amazing things are happening. You know, in the molecules, they're twisting, they're changing shape, just allowing us to smell an orange or to taste something. It's just amazing. I really love this molecule. I've got to show it to you because I call this molecule the molecule with a hole, because if you notice, it's got a hole in the middle, and you can put magnesium there and you end up with a green, and the green of the trees and the grass, or you can put iron there with a few fiddly extra bits around the edge and you end up with blood, red blood, hemoglobin. So this little molecule can create the pigments which are life, for life on this planet. It's just absolutely amazing. I'll tell you more of it later on. I don't know whether you've ever cooked spinach and it's ended up looking like this colour, rather a mucky, horrible colour. Then what you're doing is some chemistry, because what you've done is you've replaced the magnesium atom in the middle of that molecule.
Some of the most evocative smells. Civetone. It might come from the urine of the civet cat, but it's been the basis of perfumes for millennia. Geraniol and 2-phenyl ethanol. A rose by any other name would smell as sweet. The smell of a spring garden. Ionone. Newly mown hay. As the grass is cut, carotene is broken down by sunlight to make it, and that's what you can smell. Allyl propyl disulfide. Don't cry, it's only the smell of chopped onions. Nothing happens until the cells are damaged and enzymes get to work. 2-heptanone, the perfect finale to any meal. Blue cheese. Its smell is made by the fungus Penicillium roqueforti. Methyl 2-pyridyl ketone. Going to the movies? It's the pervasive aroma of popcorn. 6 evocative smells.
There is a range of reactions that human beings have to objects in their environment and the way that we think about them. I mean, everyone looking at this model, or if they could feel it, would see that it's made out of plastic. And people think of that as synthetic. And when people look at this little Russian wooden bowl here that's been painted, people recognize this as a natural object. Now, what's the difference? This is polyethylene of some type, I think. It was made from ethylene, which in turn was a petroleum product, and which, interestingly, way back started out from trees. The number of acts of human ingenuity that come between the trees that eventually wind up in this plastic and the trees that wind up in this human bowl, the number of acts of human creation is so large that people lose track. Now, this is where education comes in. I think it's interesting to see in all the synthetic things in our environment the sequence of steps by which they ultimately derive with the help of our tools and intelligence, with our minds and hands, by which they ultimately derive from the same natural world that the obvious things like a sunset or a tree is.